Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Suraj Hitches, finally a postgraduate from the Department of Radio Diagnosis. And my co-authors are Dr. Yashas Ullasel and Dr. Evan Tarbi. I'm from Thearajaras Academy of Higher Education and Research. And the title of my topic is Midline Shift and Hematoma Thickness as a Prognostic Factor of Mortality in Patients with Acute Subdural Hematoma. So need for the study is, it's acute subdural hematoma is a type of intracranial hematoma which has the highest mortality rate. The mortality rate of acute subdural hematoma ranges from 40 to 70% despite the advancement in management techniques as reported in the previous studies. And literature has shown that the radiological findings on CT like hematoma thickness and midline shift play an important role in assessing the prognosis and determining the surgical management. And midline shift more than the hematoma thickness could mean that the presence of brain edema indicating possible degree of brain injury which may worsen the prognosis. Aims and objectives of the study are to assess the midline shift and subdural hematoma thickness as a prognostic factor of mortality on initial cranial computed tomography scan of the patients with acute subdural hematoma. So coming to the materials and methods. The study was conducted on patients who underwent cranial CT scan due to traumatic SDH in our institution, and the study duration was for 3 months. And all of the adult patients aging more than 15 years were included in the study who have come with traumatic SDH, and the people aged less than 50 years and with non-traumatic SDH are excluded from the study. It was a prospective study, and 61 subjects were considered during the study. And all the data including age, gender and survival status were collected from the database, and midline shift and thickness of the SDH in the MM were estimated from the CT scan of the patients during the study duration. So midline shift was measured at the level of the frontal horns using standard window widths and window levels to evaluate the brain parenchyma, that is 86 and 30. And midline shift was defined as the displacement of the septum pellucidum in relation to the midline in the subdural hematoma was evaluated with adjusted window width and window length to minimize the underestimation of the hematoma thickness, that is of 300 and 120. And the thickness of the subdural hematoma and midline shift was compared separately with the survival status. The patient survival was considered as the primary outcome variable. Midline shift and SDH were considered as secondary outcome variables. Descriptive statistics were used to analyze the data in accordance with the objectives of the study. And the data was expressed as mean, minimum, maximum and the percentage wherever it is appropriate. And all the quantitative variables were checked for normal distribution. Non-normally distributed quantitative variables were summarized by median and interquartile range and were compared between study groups using the Mann-Whitney U-test, and the count variables were analyzed by the chi-square test expressing as a number. And the nomograms, two of the nomograms are used to distinguish these studies. Then they are evaluated by the area under the curve of the receiver and operating characteristic curve, that is ROC. And sensitivity, specificity and predictive values and diagnostic accuracy of the screening test along with the 95% confidence interval were presented. Coming to my results. So as you can see, the mean age was 65.3 plus or minus 12.5 years. And among the study population, 34 were male and remaining 27 were female. The mean midline shift was 5.45 mm plus or minus 3.68. And the mean subdural hematoma was 3.62 mm plus or minus 1.56 mm. And out of the 61 participants, 31 survived. And the mean midline shift and STS difference was 1.83 plus or minus 3.05 mm in the study population, and it ranged between 3.10 to 10.70. So this is just a representative image which I've done the study with. So here we can see a right frontotemporal parietal STS measuring 6 mm and a midline shift about 8 mm towards the left side. So this is the predictive validity of midline shift and subdural hematoma in predicting survival. This is the ROC analysis. As you can see here, the MLS had an excellent, that is midline shift has an excellent predictive validity in predicting survival as indicated by the area under the curve, 0.936, And the STH thickness had fair predictive validity in predicting survival as indicated by area under the curve of 0.799. So this is a comparison of survival status with midline shift and STH in the study population. There was a significant difference in survival status of patients with a cutoff value of midline shift of 3.94 mm and SDH of 3.35 mm. And 90% of the patients died with midline shift of more than 3.95 mm. And it was observed that when the midline shift exceeds that of the SDH, the chances of survival was poor. Coming to the predictive validity of midline shift and SDH in predicting survival. So the midline shift had a sensitivity of 90.32% and specificity of 90% and diagnostic accuracy of 90.16%. The SDH has a sensitivity of 74.19% and specificity of 76.67% and diagnostic accuracy of 75.41%. Coming to the discussion, the study included 61 patients with a mean age of 65.3 and plus or minus 12.5 years, and majority were males. And the mean midline shift was 5.45 and SDH was 3.62. The mean midline shift and SDH difference was 1.83 plus or minus 3.05 mm. So the predictive validity of midline shift was excellent and that of SDH was fair in predicting survival as indicated by the area under the curve of 0.936 and 0.799 respectively, as we've seen before. And the cutoff values derived from ROC curve for midline shift was 3.95 mm and that for hematoma thickness was 3.35 mm, above which the chance of survival was poor. So there was statistically significant difference in proportion of survival between those with the midline shift more than the SDH and those with midline shift less than the SDH. So I'd like to conclude by saying that the sensitivity and specificity of midline shift was found out to be superior in predicting the survival of the patient when compared to the hematoma thickness. And there's less chance of survival when the midline shift was more than 3.95 mm than the hematoma thickness. A uniform definition of grading and standardized method for measurement on cranial CT scan should also be applied to all the future prediction models. So